Okay then. So this is what is the input we are considering, which is normally called as a pulse input. Here you could see our input today is a pulse input. So this is what is graphically it is represented, and this is mathematically that is represented. Okay. So until t is less than 0, input is 0, and for t is equal to 0, it has suddenly changed from 0 to capital V volts, and it continues to be as capital V until a certain point of time. And at t is equal to tp, again it changed from V volts to 0 volts. Okay. And before we go ahead further, let me introduce some two important terms, right? I think you might have studied about these things in your transient analysis. Yes or no? Okay. So even if you have not learned, no issue. Okay. So let me tell you quickly, this 0 minus is just before 0. And 0 plus is just after 0. Tp minus means just before Tp. Tp plus means just after Tp. What is happening? Just before 0, just before 0, the input is 0. Okay. Just after 0, okay, the input is capital V. That is what you need to understand. Okay. So the point that we need to understand here is just before 0. Okay. In fact, it is a very small negligible time that we cannot even measure. Okay. But for our illustration, or for our analysis, we'll be go ahead something like this. 0 minus means just before 0, where my input signal is 0. 0 plus means just before, just after 0, where my input has suddenly changed from 0 volts to less V volts. Tp minus means my input is still capital V volts. Please do understand. Tp minus means just before Tp. Okay. At t is equal to Tp, your input has changed from 0 to capital V to 0 volts. But at t less than tp or at tp minus, it is still capital V. At tp plus means just after tp. Just after tp, what was happened is input changed from V to 0. So this is what you need to have an idea. So this is more than enough for deriving an expression for your output voltage when the input signal is a pulse input signal, which is being graphically shown like this. Okay. So right. So let us start now. So for finding, okay, for finding the output of any input signal to any circuit, what is all that we need to do? What is all that we need to do is, for t less than 0, okay, for t less than 0 or for t less than 0 minus, what is my VF is, what is my TI is, what is my VI is. By this time you might have aware of all these terms, VF, TI, VI, okay. And what is tau that is given in the question is RC, okay. What is VF for t less than 0? For t less than 0, input is 0. When input is 0, voltage across the capacitor at t is equal to infinity is also 0 volts. And the time at which you are applying the input over this interval is 0. And at t is equal to 0, what is the output you are looking at? When there is no input, no output, so 0 volts. This is seconds. So with these values, what is my output voltage? V naught of t is going to be 0 volts. Okay, so my output is going to be 0 volts for t less than 0. So it is expected because no input, no output. Fine, right. So the second interval that I am going to consider is over the interval 0 to tp. Okay, over the interval 0 to tp. In other words, please do understand, I am writing in the other way, something like 0 plus. Okay, t is greater than 0. That is meaning 0 plus, less than t, less than tp minus. Okay, t is less than tp, a is in other words tp minus. Okay, now over this interval 0 to tp, what is my input is? My input is capital V volts. Okay, my input is capital V volts, right? Then I need to find out my output voltage. For finding my output voltage, what is that I have to do? I know my output voltage equation is given by V naught of t is equal to VF minus vi into e power minus of t minus ti by tau. Okay, by tau. So this is the well-known equation to all of us, right? This is the well-known equation to all of us, and this is the same equation that we will be using for finding the output voltage. Okay, so now you have to sorry, now you have to tell me what is vf, what is ti, what is vi, and what is tau. Okay, tell me what is vf over this interval 0 to tp. Vf is given as anyone?
V volts.
Very good. Okay, what is ti over this interval?
Zero.
Very good. Okay, what is vi at t is equal to zero?
Zero,
because voltage zero across the capacitor cannot change instantaneously, right? Okay, what is tau is given by
RC.
Very good. So substituting these values in my output voltage equation, I'll be getting V naught of t. Okay, I'll be getting V naught of t is equal to Vf is V minus Vf is V minus Vi is zero into e power minus of t minus Ti is zero by tau. So tau is nothing but your RC. Okay. So this, when I simplify it, it is nothing but V into 1 minus e power minus of t by tau, right? This in output voltage I was denoting with, let me denote this output voltage with V naught 1 of t, okay? Over the interval 0 to tp, my output be denoted with V naught 1 of t, and it is given as capital V into 1 minus e power minus t by tau, right? Okay. In particular, at t is equal to, tp, okay? In particular, at t is equal to tp, when I consider t is equal to tp, what does it mean? Is it to be considered as tp minus or tp plus? When I consider at t is equal to tp over this interval 0 to tp, should I consider it as tp minus or tp plus? Because tp minus is indicating tp minus is indicating that my input voltage is still capital V. Tp plus is indicating that my input voltage has changed from capital V to 0 volts. Okay, so that is why it is important to understand that whether it is tp minus or tp plus. Okay, so tp minus normally, but in general I don't write it as tp minus or tp plus. Normally I'll write it as tp, but you have to understand, because this is the interval, it is normally a tp minus. Okay, so t is equal to tp, right? So my V naught of t, or my V naught 1 of t, is given as, okay, let me represent that with capital V suffix capital P. Okay, please understand, my output voltage is denoted with capital V suffix capital P at t is equal to tp. Okay, so and what is that? It is been given as capital V into 1 minus e power minus of tp by tau. Okay, so this voltage is nothing but at t is equal to tp, so that is why I was representing with capital V suffix capital P. Okay, I hope you have understood so far, right? So we have divided our input signal into, our input signal is in general from 0 to tp. What is my input signal from 0 to tp? Capital V volts. From tp to infinity, what is my input signal is 0 volts.
Zero.
Okay, so we are going to find our output voltage in terms of two intervals. One is 0 to tp, another is tp to infinity. So we have already found out over 0 to tp, our output signal is looking like this. Okay, in particular at t is equal to tp, we represented with V suffix capital P, right? Okay, then we'll go ahead and we'll try to find out the last equation, that is, so what is the last equation? So let me consider or call it as case C, where it is t greater than tp. Okay, t greater than tp, or how do I write it? tp is less than t is less than infinity. Okay, so over this interval, what is my output voltage is going to look like? Over this interval, what is my output voltage is going to look like? Again, for finding my output voltage, what is all that I need to find? What is my VF? What is my TI? What is my VI? And what is my tau? So tau is anyway RC that is given in the question. What is my VF is? For T greater than TP, that means can I consider it as TP plus or TP minus? TP plus.
TP plus. TP plus.
At TP zero, plus, sir. My input signal is zero. So that means my output at zero. T is equal to infinity will also be 0 volts. Zero volts. Very good. And TI is equal to time at which I was applying input over this interval.
TP plus.
Over this interval. TP it is plus. TP. Very good. TP plus. Okay. Just I was writing TP plus. CP, simply TP, but you have to understand that it is TP plus or TP minus. Okay, so output voltage at T is equal to TP.
We
just now we have given a representation for that. It is capital V suffix capital P. Yes or no? Just now we have represented. Okay, that is capital V suffix capital P. So with these values, okay, substitute in our output voltage equation. What is my output voltage equation? V naught of T is equal to okay, VF minus VI, right, into e power minus of T minus TI by tau. Okay, so when I substitute these things, what is the expression I'll be getting? I'll be getting an expression VP into e power minus of T minus TP by tau. Okay, VP into e power minus of T minus TP by tau. Let me denote this output with V naught 2 of T. Okay, over the interval 0 to TP, we have denoted the output with V naught 1 of T, and over the interval TP to infinity, we denoted the output with V naught 2 of T. So my V naught 2 of T is given by capital V suffix capital P into e power minus of T minus TP by tau. Okay, so here TP stands for what? TP minus or TP plus? TP plus. Okay. Oh, very good. So now let us consider three important cases. Okay, case one. I hope you have understood, right? Just we have merely used only one and only one equation, that is V naught of T is equal to VF minus VI into e power minus of T minus TI by tau. That's all. Okay. Only thing is that we are always looking for what is going to be this VF, TI, VI and tau. Right. So now what is case one is tau is much less than TP. Okay. Tau is much less than TP. What do I mean by tau is much less than TP? Look at here. TP means what? The pulse duration. Okay, here I have written that TP means the pulse duration, right? So that means duration until which your input signal is existing, that is with a value of capital V volts. Okay, so what is this pulse duration? Only over this duration, the input signal is capital V. For the, all the other duration, for T greater than TP, it is zero. For T less than zero, it is zero. So there is a certain duration which you are calling it as pulse duration. Only over that duration, your input signal is capital V, right? And what do I mean by this tau is much less than capital TP, small TP. Tau, you know, what is the tau? In the last video, I had given a new definition. The tau is the time constant or the time that is required for your output to reach 63.2% of its final value. Got my point? 63.2% of its final value. What is the final value of your output can be? Capital V volts. The time taken by your output, 63.2% of its final value, that is capital V, is nothing but the tau. So when my tau is much less than TP, what does it mean? When the tau is much less than TP, what does it mean? My input signal is looking like this. So let me draw the input signal for you. Okay. My input is TP. This is VI of T. Okay. So my input is varying like this. Okay. Suddenly it has changed from 0 volts to capital V volts. And at T is equal to TP, it has changed from capital V to 0 volts. Okay, so now my tau is given as much less than TP. So this is the length of time. Okay, this is the length of time, and your tau is much less than. Tau means what? Time taken to reach the 63.2%. That is very, very small. Okay, that is very, very small compared to this tau TP. So that means what? Your output may be reaching your maximum value, that is V, even before your TP that is being reached. I hope you are able to follow me, right? Tau is the time taken by your output to reach 63.2%, which is very less. That means even with a small duration in time, it is going to reach the maximum value because tau is very, very small. Okay, that is why I was showing the output like this, right? My voltage across the capacitor is always either exponentially rising or exponentially decaying. So normally, as your input is capital V volts, your voltage across the capacitor tries to reach towards the capital V volts. But how much time it is taking? It is taking very less time because tau is indicating that to reach 63.2%, which is much, much less than TP. And TP is somewhere here. So by the time I reach the TP, my output is going to reach to capital V volts. Okay. So this is what I will be calling it as V naught 1 of T. Okay. V naught 1 of T. Right. Yes, and over the interval 0 to TP, this is how my V naught 1 of T is going to look like. Over the TP to infinity, how does my output is going to look like? So it is going to look like something like this. After TP, your input has changed from capital V to 0. So your capacitor output also tries to reach towards the 0. And only at T is equal to infinity, it is going to reach towards the 0. So that is why I was showing like V naught 2 of. Okay, so we divided our output voltage into two parts. One is V naught 1 of T, another is V naught 2 of T. Over the interval 0 to TP, it is V naught 1 of T, and from TP to infinity, it is V naught 2 of T. Okay, so this is for case 1. Because tau is very small, your output is reaching much before this TP is. Okay, right? Okay, I'll be considering another case. Okay, I'll be considering another case where tau is equal to TP. Okay, can you draw the output waveform? How does it is going to be when tau is equal to TP? This is my input. This is my input. This is my TP. This is 0. This is capital V. So how do I represent that? What do I mean by tau is equal to TP? Tau, I know that it is the time required by your output to reach to 63.2%. That means exactly at T is equal to TP, how much is the voltage that your output can reach? 63.2%. Let us say that it is some 63.2%. Then I'll be showing my output as something like this. Okay, what is this particular value of your output is? 63.2% of your capital V, right? And from here onwards, how does your output is going to vary? Your output is going to vary to reach towards the 0. Okay, so this is V naught 2 of T, and this is your V naught 1 of T. Okay, so just try to understand that how I was representing my output. Because tau is equal to TP, I was representing at exactly T is equal to TP, my output is somewhere 63.2% of this. Okay, it is 63.2% of this capital, right? Is it okay? Right. So the last case we are going to consider, okay, the last case that we are going to consider are case 3, okay, case 3. Okay, what is case 3 is tau is much greater than TP. So what is the meaning of this? Tau is much greater than TP. So I am drawing input waveform. Input waveform is T. Input is Vi of T. Okay, here is 0. Here my input is varying like this. At T is equal to TP, it is changing from capital V to 0. Right. So what is the meaning of this tau is much greater than TP? So tau is time taken for reaching to 63.2% of its maximum value. That is very, very large even compared to your TP. That means that 63.2% of maximum value reached by your output is being taken only after TP. Okay. So that means, so my output is going to be something like this. Okay. It is going to reach 63.2% only after going ahead with TP only. Okay. Only after crossing this TP seconds, then only you may reach your 63.2% of your maximum value. Okay. So this is how my waveform is going to look like. So in the examination, you need to draw this tentative or rough sketch of your output waveform. Okay. So for drawing the rough sketch of output waveform, may not be exactly to be scaled, but at least a meaningful sketch need to be drawn. So that means for tau is much greater than TP, it is expected that your output should be much less than 50%. Okay, that is why it is shown like this. Okay, so this is what the response of your RC low pass filter circuit to a pulse input is. Okay, the response of RC low pass filter circuit to a pulse input is, right? If you have any questions, let me answer them first, then we can proceed. We'll proceed to solve one problem if you have no questions. No questions. So the question is like, you are asked to draw the output response of RC low pass filter circuit for a pulse input with a pulse duration 1 microsecond. And what is given to you is FH is equal to 10 megahertz is what is given. Okay. FH is equal to 10 megahertz is what is given. So how do we proceed? How do you proceed? What is given to you is you are given to draw the output response. This is my input voltage. Okay. This is my input voltage. This is 0. This is 1 microsecond. Is it not? What is given? 1 microsecond duration. So that means TP is given as 1 microsecond. Okay. TP is equal to 1 microsecond is what is given. Right. And we were not given the magnitude. Okay. Let us denote that with capital V on. So now we were asked to draw the output waveform, how it looks like for FH is equal to 10 megahertz. Okay. So we have drawn the output voltage roughly when the tau and the TP information is known to you. Okay. Depending upon the relation between tau and the TP, we were able to sketch the output waveform roughly. Okay. So as TP is already given to you, you need to explore what is tau is. Okay. You need to explore what is tau is. So how do you find tau is? You already know that FH is equal to 1 by 2 pi RC, where RC is nothing but tau. So 1 by 2 pi tau. So from here onwards, can you find out what is tau is equal to? Because FH is given as 10 megahertz. Okay, FH is given as 10 megahertz. So tau is equal to 1 by 2 pi into 10 megahertz. Mega means 10 to the power of 6. Okay, so what is my tau is going to be? My tau is roughly 1 by 20 pi microseconds. Okay, so this 10 to the power of 6 is a micro. So 1 by 20 pi microseconds. So can I tell what is the relation between my TP and the tau? My tau is less than TP. Okay, my tau is much less than TP. Right? This is 1 microsecond, whereas here it is 1 by 20 pi, right? So naturally, tau is going to be very, very small compared to the TP. So the case is tau is much less than TP. Can you sketch the rough output waveform for this condition? The rough output waveform, tau is very, very small compared to TP. How do I represent? I'll be representing my output as, okay, reaching the voltage capital V much before this TP is equal to 1 microsecond. Okay. right? And can you tell me what is my output voltage is denoted by exactly at t is equal to tp? Exactly at t is equal to tp, my output voltage is denoted by Vp, capital V suffix, capital P. And what it is given as? It is given as capital V. Okay? So this is what is being expected from you to draw the output waveform. Okay? Drawing a sketch, a rough sketch of the output waveform for the given condition is a very, very essential thing. Okay? So that is what you are expected from the first question. Draw the output response of RC low pass filter circuit for a pulse input with 1 microsecond duration when FH is equal to 10 megahertz. TP is given as 1 microsecond. So find out what is tau so that we can have a relationship between TP and the tau so that you can come to know that what sort of output waveform can be it is. Right? Okay? Right. Now, for the same thing, let me give you another case. Okay, for the same thing, let me give you another case so that you will be able to draw the output waveform. Let it be like FH is equal to 1 megahertz. Okay, FH is equal to 1 megahertz. For FH is equal to 1 megahertz, can you draw the output waveform? For drawing the output waveform, what is all that you have to know? Anyway, TP is given. TP is given as 1 microsecond. Okay? TP is given as 1 microsecond. Just find out what is tau is. Find out what is tau is. So tau you can find it as 1 by 2 pi FH because FH is equal to 1 by 2 pi tau. Right? So from this 1 by 2 pi FH is 1 mega. Okay? Mega is nothing but 10 to the power of 6. So RC is roughly 1 by 2 pi microseconds, right? So my TP is 1 microsecond. My tau is 1 by 2 pi microseconds. So what is the relation between tau and the TP? Tau is may not be much less than TP, but definitely tau is less than TP, okay? So now again, if you are asked to draw the output waveform, a rough sketch, okay? How you can do that? This is my input voltage. 0 here. My input voltage is looking like this. At t is equal to tp, it is changing from capital V to 0. And now you are asked to plot the output waveform. Tau is less than tp. Okay. So maybe I may draw an output voltage, something like this. Okay. Right. Just to have a difference between what is the earlier waveform that we have drawn and this time. Earlier, we have shown that the output voltage is much before the TP. Now, we have shown the output voltage reaching this capital V just before this TP. Okay? Just before this TP. Right? Okay. And after TP, it is anyway trying to reach towards the zero. Right? So, this is denoted by V naught 1 of t, and this is denoted by V naught 2 of t. Okay? Is this okay? Right. And there is a last case here that is let FH is equal to 0.1 megahertz. Okay? FH is equal to 0.1 megahertz. Again, tau is equal to how much? 1 by 2 pi, 0.1 microseconds. Because mega is nothing but 10 power 6. 10 power 6 is nothing but microseconds. Okay. This time, what is that I can tell? Tau is greater than TP. Okay. Tau is greater than TP. So how do I plot my output voltage? I can plot my output voltage as, this is my input. Okay. My input is like this. Okay. So as tau is greater than TP, that means reaching this 63.3%, okay, 63.2% of maximum value has to happen only after T is equal to TP. So that is why I was showing it's something like, is this okay? t is equal to dp, it is exactly denoted by capital V suffix capital P, right? So this is how we will be drawing the rough sketch of the output waveform when the input signal that is given is a pulse input signal. Okay, when the input signal that is given is a pulse input signal, right?